You wanna check out my superpowers, yo?
Hit me.
I'm Iron Man, baby. Now I'm Giant Man.
You mortals are weak.
What's happening, Munchers? My name is Harsh.
And I'm Shreyas.
And thank you for joining us once again on the Good, Bad, and Filmy.
Yo, bro.
And this, yeah, the Spiderman is clearly on.
Finally done with it.
Yes, one review remaining. What is that about, Bhatia?
So this is basically about, I think, the best in the pack, because it's different and it's animated and it's totally unexpected because it's Sony.
And it's so good. It is so good. We guys are talking about Spiderman Into the Spider-Verse. This movie came out last year, December,
yep.
And it blew everybody's mind. I think this is my favorite adaptation of Spider-Man
100%,
ever on screen. Any screen, big screen, small screen, any screen.
Totally.
This is my favorite adaptation of it.
Yeah.
And there's just so much to talk about this movie,
there
man.
There is, yeah. So I think the biggest thing is that what they got right is that we're not doing Peter Parker anymore.
Yeah.
Although he's a very relevant character.
Absolutely.
Here. We're doing a new Spider-Man, including Miles Morales.
Miles Morales, yeah.
And we've got six other Spider-Man with him, including Miles. So we've got Peter B. Parker, who's been played by Jake Johnson, who's been voiced by Jake Johnson from New Girl. He's awesome. We've got Spider-Man Noir.
Nicolas Cage, baby.
Who thought?
And he's on point. He nails it. The voice acting is amazing for this. Yeah.
Absolutely. We've got Spider-Gwen, voiced by Hailee Steinfeld. Yeah. I love her. She's
Everybody
so
loves
cute.
Her. Everybody loves her.
We've got Spider-Ham.
Yep.
That's like your Looney Tunes thing going on.
Yeah.
And who are we missing? Oh, and we've got Penny Parker.
Oh, yeah.
She's from way into the future, where she got this mechanized.
She's from anime land, basically.
Yeah, that's an anime thing.
Yeah.
And did we get all of them? We're missing anyone? I think
we got all of them.
I think we got all of them.
Yeah.
Cool, man. So let's just start with the goods.
Yeah, let's get into it, man.
Let's do this. So this movie captures so much in terms of, like, it's not your everyday animated movie. So the animation is just, it's like a comic book brought to life. At the same time, like, obviously we have a lot of, like our animation comes from, like, Disney stuff. And this is so different. Like, that's why it's a movie in itself. It won best animated feature.
Absolutely.
At the Oscar. Yeah. Absolutely. And there's this really cool thing where we've been watching these videos, how, like, they're breaking down the scenes and, you know, how they came up with this stuff. And basically, Jack Kirby is one of the, you know, Marvel illustrators.
Legendary, dude.
Absolutely. And he used to sort of emphasize on energy and on effects using these dots.
Yeah.
And we see that throughout the movie.
Yeah, all that style, the art, the entire form is incorporated throughout this movie.
Right.
This movie had 177
animators.
At one point.
That's insane.
Like, throughout the movie. And that's almost double the amount of
average
animated
features.
So you can actually see the amount of heart, the amount of work that's gone into this movie. And as soon as you see the first frame of the movie, it's evident that this movie is going to be something very different.
Correct.
It's something that you've not seen before. The way of the style of animation, the voice acting, everything is so good.
Totally. I mean, the voice acting pretty much, like, caught us by surprise how good it is, because obviously Miles Morales is half Latino, half black, and not just him, like his uncle, his dad, his
mom.
You know, his mom, they're all so freaking cool, and you almost feel like you're right there with
them.
And
they're all fleshed out, the characters.
Totally.
The characters are really, really well fleshed out. Every relationship, everything, anyone and everyone who's even remotely related to Miles, that relationship between them is fleshed out so well that it actually makes you care about the character.
Absolutely. So yeah, so and to bring that all together and just to, like, make it more alive on screen is the freaking soundtrack. I mean, not just the songs, but the effects and the way they're sort of backing up everything that's happening on screen is just a masterpiece.
I couldn't have put it better. I think the soundtrack of this movie gives it a soul of its own. Like,
totally.
If nothing else, it just sets it apart from all of the movies in the animated genre.
Absolutely.
Right? So the soundtrack for me, it really pulled me in.
Yeah.
So I was sold the minute you hear Sunflower, like,
oh my god,
it begins playing. Like, what an intro! What an intro to a character.
Yeah, it's the best opening scene I think I've seen of any movie.
Actually.
Yeah, so can it please do Filmy and not do Bad? Can we skip that?
I wish, but before anything else, I really want to say, so from the comics, I've always been a Spider-Man fan, but Miles Morales from the comic, I've never given a shit about, like, too much.
And
this movie got me to
put him on the map.
Exactly.
Yeah.
This movie got me to latch onto him as a character.
Yes.
I give a shit about his relationship with his uncle, his relationship with his parents, how he comes. This is like a coming of age story for him dealing with his
teenager issues,
absolutely, him dealing with his past, him learning understanding them, becoming better,
right,
and then becoming a hero, man.
Absolutely.
Of everything else.
Absolutely. So this movie just encapsulates all of that and so much more.
Absolutely.
So before we go into details, we have to do a little bit of bad.
Let's see.
Bad's coming up. Considering how good this movie is, and you just saw us like pretty much going gaga all of this, all over this stuff. But me personally, like, I enjoyed, there's a little twist with respect to Doc Ock, but in terms of like her arms, like, okay, so I know Doc Ock from Spider-Man 2, and obviously I'm hoping you've already seen the video. His mechanical arms are kick ass. It's like his four limbs plus, you know, four extra mechanical limbs. With her, it almost seems like they're like air filled and they're like plasticky or some shit like that. So I almost didn't take her seriously. And I get that, you know, Sony was trying to do something different and not do the obvious Peter Parker, Goblin, and the main, you know, villain. So they made Kingpin the main villain. But everything around him, like Scorpion is such a big villain. He was there for like a few seconds and then he just disappeared. Tombstone is very, very, like, he's not a big enough villain, but he's huge and he's untouchable and he doesn't feel pain. And here he's just like this.
He's a henchman.
He's a thug. Dude. Yeah, he's like a right-hand man. And I don't know, that didn't make sense for me. So yeah, so maybe the villains I wasn't really impressed with, but I was too distracted with everything else that's going on, so...
But to kind of counter that, I kind of understand where the, you know, creators were coming from. Firstly, establishing so many Spider-Men in this movie, right? You need to give them all that screen time so that they're kind of distinguishable in their own aspects. Right. They have their own individual personalities. They're not just different looking people with the same personality, firstly.
Okay.
So you're giving so much screen time to them that you don't have too much screen time left to dedicate to the villains. Maybe that's why they stuck with Kingpin. And they've given him sort of a backstory where he loses his, you know,
so
family.
You may want to empathize with
him. You kind of, I actually kind of did empathize with him a little, and whereas you know the different versions like Doc Ock, I really like the twist of the Doc Ock being a girl, and it's the Scorpion actually being a Scorpion, Goblin being like a huge ass goblin.
But what was that?
I think that's more of a multiverse take than you know it being the original 616 Earth take.
Fair.
I think it's that because we can't really be sure which Earth this is taking place on, and which is the actual
correct.
That's not really conveyed properly.
Right.
That's left a little ambiguous.
Yes.
So yeah, I think that's just that multiverse thing. They realized they could play around with it, so why not take liberties?
It's almost like Mortal Kombat version of animality.
Absolutely.
Like goblins, animality is like a 20-foot goblin.
Yeah, he's actually like a huge ass
goblin. But you know, I mean, enough. I mean, as much as the other villains, I don't really get and I don't really feel for. Prowler was.
He was spot on. The relationship between him and Miles Morales was established so well.
Right.
And one thing, every time Prowler was on screen, I had goosebumps.
Because it was scary.
Because of the, you know, the background music that they've given him, it's so primal that it literally gets to you.
Also,
every time he's on screen, he's chasing Miles and you're literally on the edge of your seat.
Totally.
I loved all the scenes with the Prowler.
Absolutely. So why don't we get more of this in Filmy?
Get into the details, man.
Yo, man, Filmy coming up.
Coming into the details, the film overall, there are so many types of animations which have not been, you know, used together.
Correct.
To create this movie, the making of this movie was so interesting to watch.
Totally.
Like you already said, we guys have been kind of diving into it to understand what went behind the scenes.
Yeah.
And there's just so much effort that's gone into it. There was this little one scene which was just 10 seconds and it took over a year to make.
Yeah, because they were like probably like trying different things.
Absolutely.
And they've adapted like so many different styles, and it's almost like, so basically what they did was they had like AI to like mimic certain scenes,
right?
And you know, they said the accuracy with that is 100%, but humans can bring that human error and that judgment, and we almost want it to look like a mistake and be prone to sort of errors and judgment because it looks more real then, like the expressions look more real. You don't want to look like very computerized.
Absolutely.
And stuff. So which is like the challenge I think they had from the very get-go, that we don't want it to be a typical animated movie. At the same time, we don't want it to be like a cartoon.
Absolutely,
So they did their homework, man. So props to Sony for that.
Absolutely. The kind of effort that these guys put in. Yeah. It's the first scene itself, like you said, like Miles Morales' intro here.
Oh my God.
Where he's sketching.
Favorite scene.
Right?
Yeah, and he's listening to his music. You see a big-ass Sony on the side.
Product placement, guys.
And like how like we usually like, you know, the music's on and we're hearing it probably for the first few times. So you don't know the words and you're just like, you know, humming it, you know. Yeah. With the song, and he's going. So yeah, all of the small nuances were just done so well, man. And not just Miles Morales' introduction and you know when he's getting ready for school, but even when they introduce like the original Peter Parker Spider-Man, they throw back so much from the first three Tobey Maguire movies.
I can't believe they put this from Spider-Man 3 into the movie.
Totally.
It's such a kick-ass throwback. There are so many throwbacks from the Sam Raimi.
Yeah, there's a subway save.
Absolutely.
There's the upside-down kiss, but yeah, with a twist where Spider-Man standing and MJ's upside down.
Yeah.
And yeah, and the cab crashing into the cafe. Instead of like saving, you know, MJ and like diving, yeah, he just turns around, punches it, and sits back down. Yeah, so these guys had so much of fun with this movie, and it's so evident because it translates into the audience, right?
And it translates into a very fun movie, which the audience, I think everybody had a blast with this. I've not come across one person who's had anything bad to say about this movie.
Absolutely. And yeah, I mean, we were talking about the dots earlier, the Kirby dots. So I think we're introduced to it when they do the origin bite, the Spider-Man bite.
Right.
And when he's doing his graffiti, like he's got a spray paint and he's spraying, and the, you know, camera's really up close, and you actually see paint like, you know, spread across the screen as if it's, you know, it's like out of context, but it's making it obvious that this is what he's doing.
Absolutely.
So yeah, so these small things like, you don't even catch, I think, the first go. You're just appreciating, and then when you watch a multiple, you're like, oh damn, I didn't notice that.
This movie is full of Easter eggs, this movie is full of throwbacks. This movie, like I've already said in a video before, is Spider-Man fans' wet dream.
Oh my god.
There's just so much to pick out from each and every scene. There's just something or the other in every scene here.
Right.
And as a Spider-Man fan, I was so happy with this movie, man.
Totally. I mean, we can go on and on, but I just like to mention this last thing. Like Spider-Ham. Like he's a pig who's spider, and even his nostrils are animated like the spider eyes. So if he's angry and the spider eyes go down, his nostrils will also like mimic the same thing. And yeah, talking about spider eyes, I think that was my personal favorite animated part.
Absolutely.
You know, with the original Peter Parker and Peter Ben Parker, who's played by Jake Johnson, like whenever he's doing a thing with the eyes in the suit, I mean, I'd like literally pause it and I'm like, wow, like this is so freaking cool.
Yeah.
So yeah, I mean, we could just go on and on. I mean, we have our favorite scenes, but I think the whole movie is like a freaking roller coaster.
Fantastic. Let's just get in the rating part.
Yeah, this is going to be a When They See Us rating. this is a total blockbuster for me, 100%. And I could watch it again and again just to appreciate, you know, how cool everything is going on. Just in one scene, it's the animation, the voice acting, the soundtrack, and just everything that, you know, brings it together is just beautiful. So 100% blockbuster for me.
Totally. I'm exactly with you. The sound acting, the music, man. Oof. I can't emphasize enough. There's so much good shit happening. Hip hop and Spider-Man go so well together. Yeah. I would have never thought.
This is all black stuff, right? We've got a cool Uncle Aaron. We've got Miles Morales. Hip hop had to be there. Yo.
Absolutely, absolutely. And like I already said, this made me give a shit about Miles Morales for the first time.
Yeah.
Which even the comics couldn't do.
Right.
So I would definitely give this a blockbuster as well.
Totally.
So that wraps up our review of Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. Do let us know what was your favorite scene in the comment sections below.
Before post-credit scene, man.
Finger pointing. And that was again a lot of fun.
Exactly.
He's the future Spider-Man, man.
Spider-Man.
Absolutely. I'm really looking forward to that as well. I'm really looking forward to another adaptation or, you know, something similar like this from Sony in the animated range again.
Yeah.
So yeah, let us know what you guys are looking forward to. Let us know your favorite scene in the comments below.
Right.
And yeah, like, share, subscribe as usual. Thank you for watching this video. There's a lot of Spider-Mania going on.
Yes.
Obviously leading up to Far From Home. Woo. Do make sure that you check out all the videos.
Yo.
Like, share, subscribe as usual. Be back for more, guys.
We just booked our tickets, yo.
Yeah, we're done. Get yours. See you guys soon. Cheers.
Thank you so much for watching Good Brand Filmy. We've pretty much done with Spider-Mania. We're totally stoked for Far From Home.
Yep.
If you want to follow Muncher stuff right there on Instagram, please stalk us. We need you guys. More stuff on YouTube, you can subscribe right there. And yeah, we've pretty much done what, like 6-7 movies of Spider-Man? All down below,
the playlist, baby. Yeah. Make sure you check that out. The entire Spider-Mania is on. It's real.
Yo.
So yeah, like, share, subscribe, watch the videos and be back for more, guys.
Cool. See you guys.
Cheers.